Alhamdulillah, Rabbil Alameen. Here we get started. And thank you so much for reminding me. Balkis, there are two problems here. I'm getting older and I'm resuming after a long, long time. But absolutely a gem of a girl for reminding me to start my session recording. If you lose me for a minute or two, a second or two, do not get worried. Convey the conversation on, the chat's on. I've got a frickle internet ever since the storm hit us. So hopefully we'll get into it. This is a presentation I was mentioning that I've done in a lot of places across the globe, especially in the GCC, in Qatar, Kuwait, Oman, in Sri Lanka, in Chittagong, Bangladesh, and of course across India. So I thought I'll play this game. So we're starting with something very interesting. And it's a beautiful bridge between what we were doing earlier to what we are doing now. The bridge being Seerah as the start of it, isn't it? We spoke about the Seerah. I don't know how much did you enjoy. I love my iman increased by preparing the Seerah sessions. And I'm actually looking forward to prepare the 10 major, the Hadith of Rasulullah, 10 major signs before the Qiyamah. And trust me, I've been reading something about you know, the beast, the Dajjaja. And not Dajjal, the Zahab al-Ard, the beast. And it is fascinating. Anyway, the idea of role models that I was talking about relates to the fact that we just spoke about Joseph Campbell, who said the hero's journey is very similar. First, they oppose you, then they fight you, then you win. In very short words, in the sense, any single hero you take up, from Musa to Yusuf alayhi salatu wasalam, actually it's reversed, from Yusuf alayhi salam to Musa alayhi salam, before them Ibrahim alayhi salam, after them Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi salam, two modern day heroes. Of course, they are very different leagues. You can't compare them, but it is the same principle that is being applied. First, everybody opposes you. When you start a journey, a program, when you start saying something about change, people say you are not fit enough. Then they fight you, they throw you out of the land. Every single hero, the prophets were thrown away. And then you fight back and you win. In a simple word, they follow you, they join you. As I said, the prophets, along with the prophets, I did a small audio talk. I'll share that audio talk in the group. It is, you know, I'm worried about the fatwas I get. I got a message about children loving the Avengers a lot. I said, okay, I also a big fan of Avengers. But imagine if every Avenger, we could convert them into who the Sahaba were. Then I did something very interesting. I said, you know, the Iron Man has to be Umar bin al-Khattab. Black Panther has to be Bilal radiallahu ta'ala. And I said, but these are real heroes. Our Sahaba are real heroes. And even those journey, the Sahabas, they were opposed, they were fought, and they were victorious. The Avengers, even though it's a fake, fictional world, but they're opposed and they are thrown away. If you know the Akowa Accords, right? And finally, they win. So this is what a hero's journey is all about. A hero's journey is something, inshallah ta'ala, sometime when I teach these things to you, I don't know when will you apply this in your life. Trust me, I don't know. But I am sure you will apply. I'll repeat what I said. If I was sitting there, if I was Rayyan and Zulkifar and Ilma and Balkis, and I did not know at the 17 years or around that age, what will I do with all this knowledge? But inshallah, when I become 30 and 40, I will know that I have to do something with this knowledge. And this is what the hero's journey is all about. Okay, quick science question, a very basic science question. Please tell me, at what degree does the fire burn? What's the boiling temperature? Come on, little science is what I know. Everybody could come and go ahead and tell me. Come on, Muazzam, at least go ahead, make me proud. No, come on. Thank you so much. You're asking me questions now. I know I should. I enjoy the wrong answers more than the right ones. Don't worry. It does not. That means you're attempting and I'm very proud. Balkis, that will be third degree burns, right? It will be too high. Ilma is asking me a question, but she should be telling me that's the right answer, isn't it? Absolutely. Oh, Zulkifar. No, we are not talking Jahannam. Fi Nari Jahannam. I think that's the temperature Zulkifar is telling me about. Or at least the suns. We are talking on normal temperature, 100 degrees. Interestingly, I got, see, sometimes we know the answers. 100 degree what? I want the unit. What unit am I talking about? MashaAllah. So it's 100 degrees Celsius. Thank you so much. Is where the temperature, the fire burns. What is it in Fahrenheit? What is in Fahrenheit? F. Dr. Rifa, I'm getting your answers, mashallah. Put it in the group, do not worry. What says it? What does, what, how can word it? Go Google it, come on. What's your body temperature? What's a normal temperature? I touch you and I say, oh my goodness. All right, Ilma, wonderful. There is 212F, absolutely wonderful. All right, good, you do not confuse the 100 degree and 212 degrees, right? Zulkifer, you are slowing down. I think you had a lot of fried food in iftars and that's showing up on the chats now. Fastest finger wins, right? So, you know, somebody came and told me, you know, this is, these are common things, but we get scared to answer. Remember, there are no wrong answers. So somebody said, oh, I know 100, but it must be 100 degrees Fahrenheit. And I said, look, you know, the fire burns at 100 degrees Celsius. Your body temperature is not 100 degrees Celsius. It's 100 degrees Fahrenheit. Yes, too much of break from competitive. This is youth MBA. You can be yourself. So we are looking at 212 degrees. This is Fahrenheit when the water boils, the boiling temperature, right? Now, don't worry. I'm not getting into science. What happens at 211 then? You know, 212 is good, but what happens at 211, 211F or 99C? What happens 1 degree below? 1 degree below the boiling point, what happens? Any idea? Write down your answers. Be my guest, tell me. Nothing. Okay, something happens, Zulkifer. Right? Nothing is almost very correct answer, but something happens, right? It's very hot. The water is absolutely hot. You will still be burned, right? It will scale up your skin. You will get scalds. You will get ulcers. But yet, it is not the boiling point. It is not the temperature when water is converted to steam. That's what boiling is, right? Absolutely, Mudabbir. Mashallah. You will make your science teacher, Shruti ma'am, very proud, right? It does not boil. And this is the difference between locomotives or no locomotives. Where did I go? What happened? Oh, hold on. I went somewhere very, very far ahead and I didn't want to go back and show you the screen. That very simply, you are looking at a temperature which is 99 degrees and the water does not boil. You remember the entire communication, the entire transportation dependent on this 1 degree Fahrenheit difference. If the water does not boil, there is no steam. There were no steam engines. Steam engines used to run the locomotives. No locomotive, no transport from one city to another, no exchange of ideas. The world is a stagnant village. 1 degree. 1 degree has changed the perception of what we're looking at. It is the same 1 degree that Apple uses to innovate its phone, that Samsung uses to innovate its phones, that all the companies, you don't change a huge difference. You make small changes. And that is what we're talking about. We are talking about these small changes that make a hero. You know, mashallah, one of the sheikh said a very beautiful analogy. This is an MBA-like analogy, which is why I like that a lot. Let me go to the slide itself. He said, what's the difference between a prophet and a normal person? What's common, he said? What's common between the Anbiyas, the Sahabas, the layman, the Imams, the not so good people? And we were like, you know, oh, this is a sheikh's answer. Let us think of it. And all he said, Zulkifer, very nice. And he said, all, even those who are procrastinators, even those who are not doing anything enough, what's the common thing that they have got? And they're all human beings, fair enough. Who is 2-2? You can rename yourself. So at least I can read your name, please. Yes. They all have, the Ustad said, they all have the same time, isn't it? You all have got 24 hours. But what you do with the time, the 24 hours, the difference is 1 degree. Either you can get up and open up a Zoom and listen to this 45 minutes of conversation, or you can say, no, hold on, I am too tired. I'm going to be lazy today. I'm not going to do. Either you can go and study something, write down, Usaymin is not there, but you can write down those novels one page at a time, right? This is the difference that I've realized. I'll tell you a story. Yes, SubhanAllah, it's a very interesting story. So this was a hero of something of a kind who wanted to do hiking. And as he was climbing the hike, he realized that it's a 3-hour climb. It's 3 hours to climb to the mountain's top. 15 minutes, first 15 minutes of the climb was easy. But as you keep climbing higher above the sea level, the oxygen level drops, the breathing becomes difficult. And today, who better than Corona telling us how important oxygen and breathing is? And next 15 minutes were very difficult. The next 15 minutes, 45 minutes into that, and there's a steep curve. It is so steep, it is so difficult. He says, I cannot make it. He says, it's just 1 hour into the climb and I have got 2 more hours to go. I think I'm going to give up. And he says, as these thoughts are going into his mind, an old gentleman, older than him, is walking down the hike. Just with running shoes, a walking stick, shorts, very, very relaxed, t-shirt, you know. And he says something, he says, that changed my attitude as I was climbing up. And what did he say? All he said is, it's closer than you think. All he said is, whatever you're thinking, wherever you're trying to go, it is closer. Let me just close down my session here. It's closer than you think. And that made the difference. Sometimes we give up too early or too short a time. Don't give up is what I'm asking you. And today I'm going to take you across faith, across genders, across nationalities, to different role models. Perhaps we can learn something from them. And this is what we're going to do. Inshallah, my theory part is over. That was the only theory I wanted to give you. And hopefully this is your identifying the heroes. I'm sure some of them you'll do it in one or two instant. But tell me something interesting, something amusing about the heroes. 3 things that you tell me, and only then and only then we'll go ahead. Are you playing the game with me? Are we ready? Usaimin, I see you in. That's my Shashala, which I don't think is your photograph in the DP, but still you are there. So first picture, let's see who gives me the fastest answer on the chat. Ilma beat Zulkifer last time. Let me see who is going to do. Muazzam is almost good, alhamdulillah. Sumaya, welcome. MashaAllah. Nice to see my old familiar names about. Ozair, the silent one. All right. All of you, for that matter. Welcome. First role model on the screen. So easy for you to quickly tell me. Go ahead. Tell me, who is he? Oh, Balkis is... Are you sure we are not talking Mahatma Gandhi? All right, mashallah. Now, it is so recognizable. And don't worry, I've not made it easy, difficult for you. Mashallah, Rifa and Balkis, Dr. Rifa, doing wonderful. So is Balkis. The boys are still thinking because it's too easy below their level, so they're not answering. This is Steve Jobs. Very interesting, very simple. Good start. Yeah, Zulkifer, you really, Uzair and Zulkifer, need to speed up your writing skills. Now, what do I learn? Okay, Uzair. Well, you know, it says that out of sight, out of mind. I hope you don't forget Steve Jobs. One man, if there's one word you can associate with Steve Jobs, what would that word be? Go ahead, just give me a word. Any one word that you can associate with Steve Jobs. Apple, oh, mashallah. Absolutely, I think, I don't think I have a better answer, but what I wrote down is, no, not juicy apple, innovation. I could have written on creativity, but yes, Steve Jobs re-invited the world to see it in a different way. Absolutely, Usaimin. All right, juicy and yummy apple. By the way, one word that's common to Adam alayhi salam, to Steve Jobs, who is the missing person in between? Quickly. So Adam, Steve Jobs, there's one person, the missing one. No, not Hawa. Come on, Zulkifer. I like the answer, Hawa. I like the way you're thinking very innovatively. Humans know, Usaimin. Adam alayhi salam, which is not the, it's a Christian context that he ate the apple and he was, you know, brought to earth. It's not an Islamic concept though, but it's very common. Adam, Steve Jobs. There is one more person who can be associated with the word apple. Very common word. You should have studied in your science classes. Come on. No one? No one.
The guy who discovered gravity. I forgot his name. The guy who discovered gravity. Newton. Newton.
Dr. Rifa, send me the name. Absolutely wonderful. Yes, it is Newton. Is that right? Did you recall the name now? Isaac Newton, when the apple falls down and he discovers gravity. Well, look at the scientists. They had no other work and they were waiting for the apple to fall down. Somebody told me, I wish a watermelon would have fallen down. You would not have studied gravity in school. Is it possible? Could watermelon have fallen on him and he would have died?
He would have cracked.
You would have cracked. Zulkifer, watermelons don't grow on trees. I wanted somebody to tell me that answer. All right. Sorry to pull your leg. Right, mashallah. But I love to just, you know, talk to you in that way. Alhamdulillah. Look at Arkib. He did not answer yet. But when I pull your leg, Arkib is the first one to reply. Okay. Tell me 3 things about Steve Jobs that I would love to know. Quickly. What's the name of the actor who played Steve Jobs in the movie? Steve Jobs. Difficult one, right? Usaimin, all about books now. I like, Usaimin, what you're saying, but watermelons don't grow on trees, Usaimin. But I like what you thought about it. No, Zalkifar, even I do not know, but that's one movie I did watch. But all right, what I did do is I have read Steve Jobs' biography, right? And subhanAllah, this is one of the best biographers of the world. His Walter Isaacson is the name of the biographer. And okay, Zalkifar, thank you so much for telling the actor's name. I have no idea who is he, but it's interesting just to put across and see what you can search. Michael Fassbender, okay? And his biography, oh, you've read it? Is a thick book of called Jobs. And when I read it, I went to somebody, I said, if this man were to write Seerah of Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, I think a lot more people will read about it. Trust me, Walter Isaacson, who has written amazing biographies, if we can pay him enough, and I think there are enough countries in the world, Muslim countries, we can pay them to write a Seerah in that perspective. Anyway, that's Steve Jobs for you. What is the name of the animation company that Steve Jobs have co-founded? Yes, Usaimin, that's the book. Absolutely. Can you Google the book's cover and I'll let you share the screen, or maybe I'll do it later. Wonderful. Usaimin, on that note, I've also started picking and reading his another one called on Leonardo da Vinci. Same author, very boring, but even more beautiful book cover. Zalkifar, you are right. It's Pixar. The current book that I'm reading, I'm just encouraging you to read. I'm reading a book called Creativity by Ed Catmull. He is the actual founder of Pixar. Usaimin, biographies are boring. All right, no, you should begin with some of the Sahaba's biography. We read about Khalid bin Walid in Ramadan, and it's just a different perspective. Ustad Yavar Beg, Mirza Yavar Beg is a very famous speaker, an IIT graduate from India, mashallah, a very amazing scholar. He advised me, read biographies. And of course, he meant the religious kind. But I told some of the younger people to read biographies. The next time I went and saw Isa in Bangalore, he was reading Messi's biography, Cristiano Ronaldo's and A.B. de Villiers. And I was like, I actually did not mean that, but whatever he reads, I'm okay with it. All right, this is more about Steve Jobs. He was thrown out from his own company. And yet, look at this man. Amazingly, he creates a company which calls him back. Something so much we can talk about it. All right, enough of Mr. Jobs. Let me go to my next picture. On your screen is the first picture. Guess who is he? Zalkifar, I'll try to keep it. I think we'll extend it till 10, your time. I think you're talking Malaysia time. But we will always 1 hour or else 45 minutes, Zalkifar. So I said we will plan to do it. It's okay. Anybody? No, don't be sorry. It's okay. Anyone with this picture? No one? Can I go to the next one? Wrong guesses are allowed, by the way. It's okay to guess it wrong. Absolutely okay. No one? Okay. Easy now. Come on, Arkib. Justin Bieber. I'll make a note of the... All right. Look at... Usaimin, no. Yes, Zalkifar, I like your Sergio Origo, but somebody got the t-shirt right and the tattoo right. And Usaimin is very, very confident now. Now you know him. I think this must be an old picture. Well, okay. You are right. It is Lionel Messi. Oh, it is a new picture with a beard, mashallah. You know, I was told beards are the new six packs. Six packs, they call them, right? I've got eight, so I don't remember. But mashallah, it's nice to see the men coming up and accepting the sunnah. At least even if it's a fashion, I'm proud of it that people are having beards now. You know, it's wonderful. All right, tell me three things about Messi that I don't know about. I have no idea, Usaimin, what you've written down, but it's interesting. Okay. Tigonal Tiggy. All right. One thing I can tell you about Lionel Messi is, okay. He has short issues. He's from Barcelona, Ozer. I get it. Arkib says some short issues when he was young, as if he was a short man. I think about that. But your talent takes you a lot of places, isn't it? Messi is not from a very rich family. Buenos Aires, where he grew up in Argentina, is a very dilapidated slum. And yet, subhanAllah, if your talent is there, he's picked up by Barcelona. He was actually picked up by Real Madrid and Spain when he shifted from there. Is that right? I hope I'm not giving you wrong information. And he grows up. By the way, Messi captained Argentina to what level in the World Cup? Any Messi fans here? And my second question is, who is the coach of Barcelona? Let me quickly get some answers. He has some human created from God, from a piece of clay. Khalaqtana teen. You know, so Usaymin is getting into some philosophical part here. All right. Okay. No one else, any trivia, any information on Messi that I can go, or can I go ahead now? Not too many Messi fans, if I realize now. IDK, all right, it's okay. We'll skip Messi and we'll go ahead. Ronald Koeman is okay. Uzair Jazakallah, that must be the coach's name, and that is wonderful. Okay, not a very difficult one to find out. Who is this lady? Yes, Zalkipar, it's a coach's name. Good. Not difficult. All right. You are on the dot. So is Rifa and Balkis. Absolutely clear. Anyone else want to attempt now? Because you got the answers here. Malala Yousafzai, the youngest Nobel Prize winner, speaks about the effort education can create. Tell me three things about Malala now. Malala is now a citizen of which country? Canada? Okay, America? All right, so Malala moved to UK and she did go to Canada. She got an honorary citizenship of Canada, but she is a UK citizen now. Of course, originally from Afghanistan-Pakistan belt, who was shot down because of, you know, going to school. Very interesting biography. What's the name of her biography? There are two things around Malala. Her biography and a documentary, which is also very interesting. If you can, just watch the first 10 minutes of the documentary and you will be amazed at the history of Afghanistan and the way women stood up and encouraged men. So I realized that she was, the documentary is very interesting. Yes, Balkis, she was shot because she was a girl going to school. Yes, you are right. If that's what you're mentioning, that, you know, subhanAllah, I think as proud Muslims, educated Muslims, we are very clear. We know that Islam is for education for everybody. But you know, a girl had to be shot, and whatever controversy the media created is something that I stay away from. But at least we are aware of who this lady is. Okay. Or I Am Malala is the name of the book and the documentary. The name of the documentary is He Named Me Malala. It is from the perspective of her father, right? Yousafzai. Very interesting perspective. The first 10 minutes is what I recommend. If you can watch it as part of your school project, please do it. My next category and my next hero is this. Now, this is too much of football. I'm sorry, I should have not done football again in the first round. But look at those people. Look at Salah Firoz. All right, tell me three things about Salah. And I will run away. I will not. I already had a Salah quiz last time where we had his daughter's name. He's an Egyptian, plays for Liverpool. His daughters, we spoke about the two daughters that he got. But one thing I learned about Mo Salah, Mohamed Salah, is the perseverance. This man does not give up. He is a horse-like workman, supporting, encouraging, very low profile. MashaAllah, you can survive in the world of football, not by being very flashy, not having any tattoos, but by being who you are. And that is what Mo Salah or Mohamed Salah teaches us. One thing I love about Liverpool is promise. You know, Sumaiya, very interestingly, you mentioned about Liverpool fans have a song on Mohamed Salah, where it is said that if Mo Salah scores a goal, we don't mind to be what he becomes. We will all become Muslims. It's a beautiful rhythmic song. And, you know, maybe we should, somebody, if you can search it, we should play that song. And you should, at least you can put in the group. I would love to hear you share the YouTube link of this Liverpool song on Mo Salah. Right. Okay. Who is this gentleman? Okay, interesting, Sumaiya. Okay, Mufti Mink from Zimbabwe. Anyone else wants to guess on the first link? Zalkifer also says the most popular. Okay, I'm hearing another name, Sheikh Sudais, because of the headgear, the khafiya that he's wearing, Balkis? Question mark. All right, Asim Al-Hakim, I am amused at the answers. Maybe the beard will give away. You know, Mufti Mink's beard is different from this. Asim Al Hakim's beard is also different. You gave me the answer, mashallah. Most of you are correct on the night angle. Oh, Zair comes with a new answer. Mishari Rashid Al-Afasi, and he is Sheikh Abdul Rahman As-Sudais. Isn't it? Subhanallah. Very, very beautiful voice. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has blessed him. He's called the night angle of the haram with the way his qirats are. You must, you know, if you have recited the qirat behind him, you would be, you know, it's a privilege, it's an honor. And I keep saying that may Allah preserve him, hafidahullah, because my grandfather went to haram and he prayed. Hold on, give me 1 minute. Absolutely, mashallah, Balkis, that was nice. The Makkah background was the key. So, you know, I always say that my grandfather, my late grandfather, when he went to Haram in probably for his Hajj, he prayed behind Imam Sudais. My father went and mashallah, he prayed behind Imam Sudais. I had gone a few years back and I had prayed behind Imam Sudais. And I have my dua that my daughters go to Haram and may Allah preserve our Sheikh and they can pray behind him. Isn't it amazing, mashallah, what we learn from the Ustad, how he has preserved himself? We think of athletes, you know, we just spoke about Mo Salah and Messi, and we think of athletes preserving themselves. MashaAllah, his voice, may Allah preserve him. Hafidhahullah, by the way, not just him, all the Qurras of the world where they carry the Quran, these are the efforts. And I love this part of Imam Sudais. I'll tell you a small anecdote, very interesting anecdote. By the way, he's a very rich man. Imam Sudais, MashaAllah, is, alhamdulillah, you know, he's, you can call him a billionaire, but a very big billionaire. MashaAllah, give away his wealth. And of course, something very interesting anecdote about Imam Sudais is when he was a young boy, you know, he was absolutely kinesthetic. What do I mean? Kinesthetic? Someone like Zulkifar who would not sit in one place. I hope you can hear me again. So just give me a quick thumbs up. So on the chat, just tell me. So he would not sit in one place. He was, in a simple word, he was very mischievous. And he would just be one place, another. And look at our mothers. Tell the story to your mother and mashallah, she'll be happy. Go ahead. You know, this is one story I want you to tell your parents. And despite the mother being angry, she made a dua for him. Right? In Arabic, there is no, in Urdu, we say baddua. There is no supplication against. You make a dua. And she made a dua. She said, Ya Allah, make my son stand in one place for a few hours in a place where she cannot move away from. So because he would not sit in one place, she made a dua, Allah, do something where my son stands in one place for hours together and he cannot move away from them. And Allah accepted the dua and Imam Sudais stands in front of the haram for a few hours reciting, you know, the Taraweeh and he cannot move away from there. Wallahi, what an amazing dua of the mother and how Allah accepts the dua. So, you know, do whatever you do, mashallah, always make good duas for your family members, especially tell your parents this dua. Say, Mom, even if I'm not getting up for Salah, even if I'm hurting you so much, make sure you only make good duas for me. And this is one dua that I love, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accepted, and Imam Sudais was right there in the haram with dua of the mother. He could not go away with. And in fact, some people say she was specific about the haram, but Allah alam. Fair enough. Anyone wants to add anything for Imam Sudais? How many of you have prayed behind Imam Sudais, like live? How many of you? Did you lose me or I did not get any answers from you yet? How many of you prayed behind Imam Sudais Zulkifar? Like when you were in Haram and... Okay, Alhamdulillah, Balkis. So probably you would have prayed behind him. The Imams do change. There is, there is Ustad Hudayfi in Makkah, in Medina. There is Shuraim, mashallah, in Makkah. And then many other new scholars and ulemas. But these are the most popular ones, perhaps not when the world did not know a lot of more technology. That's why they were very popular. All right, inshallah, may Allah make you all go. Mahir al-Muhaikni, absolutely. Very, very popular, Zulkifl. Jazakallah for bringing that up. But it's okay. Fair enough. But you should know your scholars and your qaris. Alhamdulillah, just love them. Some people, my favorite qari is Abu Bakr al-Shatri. Some of you may like, most popular one is Sheikh Mishari al-Rashid al-Ifasi. But everyone have their own choices. But whatever makes you memorize and love the Quran. Alhamdulillah, Zulkifl. All right. So this is a section on reflection. And as I said, I'm keeping it short. I'm going to do a reflection with you. And I'm going to ask you, what did you learn from these scholars, these people around? Make it short, condense. Do the same thing, similar thing in the next week. And then we'll take a full head-on youth MBA session on a session called Talk from next Thursday. So next Tuesday, you'll have an SDG session. Next Thursday, you'll have a talk session. And this Thursday, something similar to what we are doing today. Today, when I reflect on this, there is a very popular series called the Peanut Series. You know, the Peanut Series, the creator of it is Charles Schulz. He says a very interesting point. He says, today we know the world around us. We know a lot of leaders, characters, actors, sports stars. Sometimes we forget the people who are close to us. This COVID situation taught us that even if you're so close to people, you cannot practically, because of the situation, and that is when you value people. Sorry. Here is a very interesting conversation. Can you all name the Champions League winner, or probably forget the current Champions League winner? All of you following the Champions League will be able to shoot the answer right now. Oh, mashallah, I get a lot of disheartened Manchester City fans. Uzair is a Chelsea fan, now I know that. Mashallah, so you know. All right, Sumaya, I'm glad you follow football as well. So Chelsea, can you name the last two presidents? Okay, Uzair, it's Mumbai Indians. And this year, the IPL has been cancelled, so we don't know who the winner is. Okay, Zulkifl tells me Trump and Joe Biden. Wonderful, so you know these heroes, absolutely wonderful. Name any three people who you can recall whose names have appeared on the Time magazine cover. Okay, in fact, Barack Obama and Trump, both the answers, it suits them. They had been on the Time magazine cover also, and they were the US president. So Bilkis, I take your answer as both. Tell me something more. It's okay, Zulkifl. Even I don't read the magazine. I think it's a very boring magazine. But you know people, you know, a lot of people have come on the magazine cover. Not always good people, but just think of some heroes. Probably, except for Mohammed Salah and Sheikh Sudais, all the people I spoke to you about have come on the Time magazine cover, including the President Imran Khan, including Justin Trudeau, including Prime Minister Modi, including MBS, Mohammed bin Salman. These are the people, politicians around the world who have come in. So you almost know everybody. Malala, yes, she's come on the cover, being the youngest winner of the Nobel Prize. All right. Greta Thunberg has come in, Bilkis. Absolutely wonderful. You are doing good. So you know your heroes very well. Now, Charles Schwitz says something even more interesting. He said, tell me these now. This is your circle. One teacher who has aided your journey, or it could be just one coach, one mentor who you really think have helped you in this COVID year. Who do you think you enjoyed in that one entire year? You went to school, you did online sessions. Who is that one person who really, really you think as a role model? Give me one name. Now here, I expect all 14 of you to give me some answers now. So please go ahead and tell me one person that have helped you in your journey. One teacher. All right, Zulkifl, Jazakallah for embarrassing me. Barakallah feek, mashallah. So, alhamdulillah. Zulkifl, Jazakallah khair. And I hope I can be a good mentor to all of you. Barakallah feek. The world around, go ahead, tell me more. You make me happy. But tell me more. Someone you've been in the online classes, people who've taught you, people who have, inshallah ta'ala, said something that you remember. Okay, nobody wants to name their role models. At least can I go to the second point? Can I find out two friends that you really, really can count on? You can WhatsApp it. They are the only ones who like your pictures on Instagram. That's only two friends you've got. Go ahead, tell me those names. MashaAllah, Rayyan, Zalkifar, Usaymin, Uzair. Tell me the names. Come on, MashaAllah. And write down your names on the screen so I know who I'm speaking to. Two friends. At least if you have two friends, write yes so I know. Okay, Alhamdulillah, there you are. MashaAllah, Shasha and Zaina, Abdullah and Ahmed. Wonderful. So strange, Zalkifar. Your both friends begin with A and your name starts. So it's A to Z. Zalkifar is doing the Amazon of friendship. Ilma, that's interesting, MashaAllah. Good friends you've got. Tell me some more. Where are the others? Where are my Rifa, Muazzam, Mudabbir? Muazzam, Mudabbir, I expected a teacher's name from you who's going to come and do our SDGs next week, inshallah. Your favorite and my favorite SDG teacher. Right, Rayyan. Okay, Uzair. Is that you, Uzair? That's called narcissist. You only like yourself or there's some other Uzair? Okay, Sumayya, I like that. The diary of Anne Frank, we got a diary of Sumayya Ibrahim and Halira. Well, Alhamdulillah, that's good. And Sumayya, your father is a great role model, a mentor to so many. My good friend and a mentor. I would name him as somebody who has taught me so much in the last 6 months I've known him. Arkib, in his own, short form style, have Zal as his best friend. And we all know who that Zal is, mashallah. Good, Alhamdulillah. The Zalzala that he brings. Wonderful. Okay. Tell me three people who have taught you something worthwhile. And it could be not necessarily anybody. It could be a friend also. It could be a neighbor. It could be someone you just, went online. It could be a businessman. No, Rayyan is not answering today. All right, Zalkifar, Jazakallah for including me in this very auspicious group of your parents. May Allah bless you, your parents, and all of you for that matter. Now, what I want you to do is go ahead and really find that one person. MashaAllah, all of you should go and just say, in the group, go and say Jazakallah to, MashaAllah, coach, ustad, mentor, Ibrahim bhai. The fact that his initiative comes in and we do youth MBA. And I'm not doing it because, I have to do it. MashaAllah, I genuinely feel that what he created, leaving his job in Kuwait, coming down, starting a program like that. I mean, he's someone you don't know so much, but you've seen his good Muslim mindset. Go send a gratitude message to him on the youth MBA group itself and say, Jazakallah, uncle, you've been amazing for you to start something. Yeah, I hate you because of what you started, my parents now forced me to sit in youth MBA, but it's okay, isn't it? I still enjoy these programs. Go ahead and tell somebody. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَلَاِنْ شَكَرْتُمْ أَزِيدَنَّكُمْ. Go thank people. Go make people feel blessed. Right? MashaAllah. Okay. Ibrahim. No. He is, MashaAllah. So you've combined the two names together. I am Dawood Waid and he is, Muhammad Ibrahim, Dr. Muhammad Ibrahim. So please go ahead and tell him, Jazakallah, anybody for that matter. Oh, MashaAllah, Arkib, that's nice. The motivational speeches that you've heard, MashaAllah, may Allah bless you, Arkim, may Allah bless you, Balkis, for all the love that you give. But this is the time you tell people about it. Now, when I think of role model, this is what I think of. I'll tell you a story and we'll end our session, as I promise you, in the condensed time that I'm trying to consider, that you all enjoy the session, you'll go ahead. And it's a beautiful story of a role model. Of course, the role model I'm talking about is no one other than the best role model anybody has ever got. لَقَدْ كَانَ لَكُمْ فِي رَسُولِ اللَّهِ أُسْوَةُ الْحَسَنَةِ. And of course, there is no one better. We did a Seerah series. So as I said, this is more like a culmination of what I want to end with. But think of this young boy whose name is, he's a dark black boy in Medina. Can anybody guess his name? This boy is so dark. He's a son of a slave. His hairs are like those, short hairs that people are like, oh, come on. He's like dark and ugly. That's how people considered him. Anyone? All right. He is not, MashaAllah, I like the name Bilal, but he's a young boy. Bilal was an old man by the time he reached Medina, right? Not old, he's like 30s at least. This boy is like 16. He's your age. I'm talking about this your age. He is a slave boy, a slave himself, a lovely name. He was sent as the leader of an expedition after Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam passed away, and he's the son of Zaid. Subhanallah, Arkib, you're almost there. He's Ibn Zaid or Bin Zaid. Zalkifar Yasir was one of the first Shaheed's son. Well, lovely. I love the answer. Rokia gives me the answer. Osama bin Zaid, radiallahu ta'ala an. Now, one day, One day, a Roman soldier comes to Medina, and as he goes on, he goes to meet Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Usama will come. Our hero will come. Usama means young lion, right? I love the name Usama radiallahu ta'ala. So this Roman soldier gives his coat to Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam as a gift. And Rasulullah wears the coat. It says it's a greenish tinge coat or brownish coat. I love the color brown, so I'll stick to the story of brown coat. And this Roman soldier said, I have seen the kings wear the coat. The Caesar wear the coat and Caesar's father wear the coat. I have not seen any man more beautiful and handsome wearing the coat than Muhammad ibn Abdullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Fair enough, the story ends. Rasulullah in his own nature takes the coat away. And there's this young Osama bin Zaid, all of 16 years old. He gives the coat to Osama, gets gift for you, take it. That's it. Rasulullah did not have a wardrobe full of Nike, Adidas shoes, not Louis Vuitton that he wears. He just gives them away. So now Osama bin Zaid now wears the coat and goes around in the markets of Medina. In the souk, the Roman soldier also is there. Maybe he's overstayed one day. He took a Marriott or an Oyo room in Medina and he's staying over. And now he sees Osama wearing the same coat. This Osama bin Zaid, a slave boy, the dark, ugly, and ugly not in the sight of Allah, wallahi. Ugly because Sahabas used to say, in the Seerah writer said, he was very ugly in the sense his looks were like those, you know, and a slave boy. So again, further down. And he says, Osama, this boy is wearing the coats that the kings would wear. He called him, shh, come here. And Osama said, what happened? He said, you know the coat that you're wearing? This coat was worn by the Caesar and Caesar's father. And you slave boy, you're wearing the coat? And Osama bin Zaid is not like, oh, I'm so sorry. He's like, oh, I don't know. I'm so sorry. He's not like that meek and young boy. Neither is he an arrogant man. He says, who, you know, why do you care? He's in between. He's balanced. He said, you come here. And he tells him, you know what? The coat that I am wearing, my father, we are better than the coat that your king wore and his father wore. You know why? Because we say, Ashhadu Allah ilaha illallah. Washadu anna Muhammad Rasulullah, you, your king, and his father do not show that. Wallahi, look at the confidence that emanates from having the right role models, from Iman in his heart and knowing who you follow. And this is the culmination of what we're talking about. MashaAllah, you know, we need that kind of conviction and you need that kind of heroes. And Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the Sahabas, gives us a long list of heroes. And then you also need mentors to coach you in your everyday life. Inshallah, go reach out to your mentors, meet them, say thanks to them. Inshallah, may Allah make me one of those that you love and you can be coached. But this is a journey that we started of role models. And I hope I can guide you. I hope the Youth MBA is a platform for you, as I said, to learn things that you will require as you go ahead and succeed in your life. On that note, Jazakallah khair. We, you know, inshallah, I hope you enjoyed. We hope we're finishing off little balance again, 10 minutes early than before. And you learn something. Barakallah feek. Any questions or give me a thumbs up and we'll end the class. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. I'll see you again Thursday 6:30. Tayyab Rokia, Tayyab, mashallah, Balkis, Jazakallah Ilma. So I can see all of you. See you. Adios, Arkib. I love, mashallah, the way you all reply. Sumaya, wonderful. Convey salams to your father. And I see all of you, inshallah, Muazzams, the M&Ms, everybody else, Uzairs. See you next week. See you this Thursday, inshallah ta'ala. And then we'll start a program, the talk and the SDG again next week. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.